Let me get this right, sir, because it's very important. She was, after all, a national leader. What you're saying is that Mr. Rehman Malik made that call after the blast, and he was told that Benazir Bhutto is fine and she's going to be taken to Zardari House, after which you made the decision to go to Zardari House. Is that correct, sir?
I'm saying exactly like that, yes.
Right. So it was Mr. Rehman Malik's decision to actually go to Zardari House. Now, looking back, sir, don't you think that since this Mercedes-Benz was a backup vehicle, you perhaps should have gone back to the scene and made sure she was all right?
No, look, what I'm saying is that I don't even know whether this was a backup car. All that I knew, if it was a backup car, then so many people should not have been traveling in it. Then, number one. Number two, this car should have been behind Mohtarma's car instead of being in front of Mohtarma's car. And since I know that Taukeer Kaira and the other vehicles, they were also protecting, because of my experience of yesterday, that is on 26 December when we went to Peshawar together, and I knew as to how were they providing protection. So I thought that there were vehicles behind. But what was their protocol? Which was the backup car? Only the security plan would know and the security in charge would know about it.
Right. And is there going to be an internal investigation? I know you have said time and time again that there will not be an internal investigation. But after such a scathing UN report, don't you think that there is a need for an internal investigation within the Pakistan People's Party?
No, I'm sorry. I never said that there will not be an internal investigation. Why not? I think
so. Some of your party members have been saying that there may not be an internal investigation.
Look, lady, I'm frankly speaking, I'm not part of the decision makers. Therefore, I do not know what they are saying and what they are thinking. All that I know is when I was traveling with her a day earlier, when I traveled with the procession on 27th of December, this is what happened. Rest, what are their decisions, what is their protocol, who was in charge, what was their security plan? All that I know is that the security was far from satisfactory. And I think this is not how you provide security to a top leader of the country.
Okay, the security was far from satisfactory, and do you blame the Pakistan People's Party as well for that, sir?
Well, look, the point is Pakistan People's Party is only in a sportive role, because Pakistan People Party doesn't have the experts to stop the traffic, to stop the crowd, and, you know, carry out barricades or, you know, get onto the rooftops with their guns, etc. Actually, the responsibility is that of the government. Now, as I look at it, Pindi it falls in provincial government. So I guess it should be the provincial government who should have provided them all the security.
Okay, you say that you should have provided them all the security, sir. Unfortunately, during this interview, we have been trying to get in touch with all of the Pakistan People's Party members. However, none of them have really taken our calls. So why is it that you are now shying away from the media? Why do you think the People's Party is shying away from the media on this particular question?
I think the question can be answered only by them who are shying away. I'm only giving you the facts. And I'm telling you, since if I were part of the decision makers or part of the plan, then I would have known as to what is the protocol and how is to be security provided, who's contacting who. I'm afraid I am only giving the facts. As far as I'm concerned, I was only 24 hours old in Pakistan People Party.
Right. You said you were 24 hours old, but you perhaps were part of the most dramatic occasion or the event that took place within the Pakistan People's Party. Looking back, do you think that what happened that day, do you think that some of the Pakistan People's Party leaders, and let me give you names here, Mr. Rehman Malik and even retired General Imtiaz, who was also part of Benazir Bhutto's security, do you think that they acted irresponsibly? Because that's what the UN report says.
Well, look, I am nobody to comment. As I said, unless I knew what was the plan, I would not be able to point
any
finger on anybody.
All right. Thank you, sir, so much for joining us. Thank you so much for joining us. We have also on the line Pakistan People's Party senior leader, Mr. Nayar Bukhari. Nayar Bukhari Saab, welcome to the show. My first question to you, sir, is will the Pakistan People's Party hold an internal inquiry determining exactly why there was such an inexcusable event that took place, whereby the Mercedes, that was the backup car of Benazir Bhutto, actually left the scene when she most needed it?
Thank you. In fact, you know, must be knowledge of it that already interim challan has been submitted in the ATA court, and there was another inquiry also, and the order sheet of the court is available, where the request had been made that the inquiry is being made by FIA, and certainly whatever are the observations given in the commission's report, you know, whether it is A, B or C, those would be examined by that inquiry committee, and then the supplementary challan would be submitted. So it depends upon the material which would be collected by the investigating agency.
All right. And now the Interior Minister, of course, is Mr. Rehman Malik. He's at the center of this controversy. So what should we hope, sir? Will this be a fair and a transparent investigation? Can we hope
surely,
that?
Surely, obviously, what we feel is this, that investigation would be free and fair, and all the material which is available. One thing I tell you, there are two...
So let me just ask this question of you because it's a very important question and people are really concerned about this. Are you going to have some kind of a mechanism? Are you going to implement a mechanism to make sure that this inquiry is free and fair and transparent?
Every political worker, and particularly People's Party worker, is looking forward for having independent inquiry and trial, you know, where the courts are independent and the culprits should be booked. Now there are three...
So, Nayyab Bukhari sahab, who is going to do the investigation?
Let me finish it now. There are three aspects of this case. The first is the criminal conspiracy. The second is the criminal negligence. And the third is the actual incident itself. So, in this regard, all the material which is available or which would be collected by the investigating agency.
And the investigative agency, sir, is going to be a civil-led investigative agency, like intelligence agencies?
That is already in process, you know, that is already in process. The court orders are available where at many dates, you know, there were requests was being made that the investigating agency would certainly submit a supplementary challan for that.
Right.
And the interim challan is already before the court.
Right. Sir, there was also a lot of controversy surrounding who paid for this UN report. Now, Pakistan, I understand, only paid seed money. So where did the bulk of the money come from and how much exactly did Pakistan pay?
That is not in my knowledge, at least. The actual amount which was required to be paid to the commission, that obviously the government of Pakistan would have paid it. And that is what it is in my knowledge, you know. And let's not speculate. We must think on the positive aspects of this commission report, you know.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us on this show. We have been trying to get in touch with several people who were named in the reports, one of them being retired General Hamid Gul. He did promise us that he will come to this program. However, we were not able to get in touch with him. His phone was switched off. There are still a lot of questions that remain unanswered in the assassination of Benazir Bhutto, and one can only hope that now that the Pakistan People's Party is in power, finally this mystery will be solved. There will be much more to come here on Express 24/7, so stay tuned, and for now, goodbye and thank you for watching.
Express 24/7.